The National Assembly's Budget Committee met to scrutinize the Constitution Amendment Bill sponsored by Tiaty MP Kassait, kamket, which seeks to change the mode of governance from a presidential system to a parliamentary system. Kamket, taking the chance to defend the cost of change in governance, saying his aim was to heal the country from the cycle of divisive politics that occurs every 5 years.
If you look at the cost of doing a demonstration, of buying tear gas, if you look at the cost of destruction of property, if you look at the cost of keeping the policemen on the streets to take care of those demonstrators, if you look at the cost of trying to shadow Mheshimiwa Raila Odinga Kalonzo Musyoka to ensure that they don't take their oath. If you look at that cost in compared to the positive cost of keeping them in parliament so that they can help to keep the government in check, that is a very minimal cost to pay, and it's a positive cost in my opinion.
The first-time MP thereby proposes reintroduction of the position of Prime Minister, who will be elected by parliamentarians and bestowed with executive powers. The president will therefore be ceremonial and basically act as a symbol of national unity. Kamket proposes that the president, MPs and governors be elected by Kenyans, while senators are elected by members of the county assemblies. According to the proposed law, the position of woman representative should be abolished since her constituency is adequately represented by senators and governors.
When you look at the position of the women representative, fundamentally, they share, a woman MP shares a constituency with the governor and with the senator. They share that constituency together. Only that one of the three officials, the women representative, the governor, and the senator, one of them is, in my opinion, is lost, which is the women representative.
Budget committee members, however, questioned how the bill would promote inclusivity in governance when the majority party had a chance to dictate the election of the prime minister.
To what extent is the proposal looking out the extent at which, if it were to be replaced, it will bring inclusivity in this country? Because if you look at it again keenly, it is parliament generating the president, it is parliament generating the prime minister. And definitely one party or a coalition of parties can easily get up with the same presidency and can also get the same prime ministership. So to what extent then are we addressing the issue of inclusivity?
This proposal is still at the early stages. We are open to all manner of improvements. And when, by the time we will be taking a vote, even to attain the two-thirds in parliament, so much will have happened. And so much improvement, I believe, will have taken place, and will have taken the views of everyone. And I believe that at the end of it all, in the fullness of time, we will have an opportunity to have one whole omnibus bill in terms of referendum.
If approved by parliament, the bill will have to be subjected to a referendum, since it alters the principles of governance. Kevin Wachira, Channel News.